Guys, hi, how are you?
Hi.
Well, good to see you.
This is Geraldine Shanks, Mr. President, the woman who's got saved.
Hi, hello there.
This is Sally Snowberg, a teacher who taught him.
We have you all turn around for one quick picture there, and then we'll bring everyone else in.
Mr. Hoffman? Stephanie Hannah, Scott's current teacher. Nancy D. Martin, principal.
So why don't we all get here in a group for a total group picture?
Why don't we get one more person? Who's,
Well, you know there was a Scott, Hoffman in my life at the beginning of the campaign. And the funny thing is, I had just been telling our people, our staff members, about Hyman.
Is that right?
And on the way, all of a sudden, I swallowed a peanut. And you know, there are times when you can still get down there, and I close my eyes, absolutely closed. And I got up and started to step across Nancy, and she saw it, and she just said, "You can't breathe." Well, the stewardess thought in the plane that there was a lack of oxygen, maybe, and was starting to run for an oxygen thing. And Mike David was sitting across the aisle, and the one I just told a few days before turned me around
and did it. The
hug. Out went the peanut.
Yeah, but this
Scott.
Listen, well, that was just great. Thank you very much.
Well, you wore that up on the farm.
Somebody has said a hero is no braver than anyone else. He's just brave 5 minutes longer.
Yeah. 5 minutes that counts.
Well, thank you very much. Well, incidentally, I have a few souvenirs for all of you, too.
Oh, thank you.
This is a jar with a seal engraved on it, the presidential seal, and contains jelly beans. In case you won't want to open this, you get home, and you and your sister might want something, there's a little sample of what's in the jar. There is a little charm with the seal for the young lady.
Thank you.
And a key ring for her father. If you ladies here, these are bookmarks.
Thank you.
Well, I thank you. My pleasure right there.
And there are some other gifts that they're going to give you later.
What's that?
And there are some other gifts that we brought that they're going to give you later on Wednesday.
Well, thank you very much. Be the other way around. That was just great.
You're so crazy.
When I made that phone call, you know, I never knew what I'd be standing here. I'm like, yeah, I'm there so sharp. I thought when they called me from the school, you know, I thought, oh, come on. There's so much pull in my leg. And then when she got on the phone and verified it, I said, I'm a nurse. I've been a nurse wreck ever since.
I was listening to everybody who was on the phone.
Women, I've been to our school.
We
only like 5 minutes. We came maybe by air.
Mm-hmm. And see, of course, you know, when you play psycho in a group.
Yes.
Yeah,
so we have a big group there.
Well, I keep it. Where did, would that be from Camp David?
Smithsburg. Do you know anything about Smithsburg? It would be to the west of Camp David.
West of Camp David.
Hagerstown. Near Hagerstown.
It's about a half an hour away or so, isn't it?
It's about 20 minutes. Mm-hmm.
From here.
No, from Camp David.
Oh, 5 minutes by air.
Yeah.
When you're flying into Camp David, we're all, you know, just listening for those helicopters, and it's very close by.
Right.
You're our neighbor. But unfortunately, we race horses on our farm, and we just come down and start riding.
Well,
Appaloosas.
Uh-huh. They had an Appaloosa standing there too.
We started off with the stallion and the mare, and now we've got quite a herd.
I don't want to take care of all those.
It's not bad.
It's bad enough taking care of town.
Congratulations. Mm-hmm. Thank you for everybody.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's nice meeting you.
No, it's good to meet you.
Very nice meeting you. Thank you, Mr.
President. It's experience of mine.
It is for me too.
She's busy.
She's busy eating jellybeans.
You're even
more
handsome than
your
pictures.
You are.
I'm
very
nice.
I'll see you.
That makes my day. Hi, Ryan. I love you.
She said, I love you.
Well, I love you. You ladies know the poem by, oh, what's it, Clark Monoff, the teachers? I can't recite it, ladies. It's a wonderful poem.
I'll have to look it up.
You are the keepers of their dreams. It goes on from there.
Give our best to Nancy.
I sure will.
Is she all right?
Just fine.
And she got a sweatshirt just like that.
Would you tell her that I...
They have a sweatshirt for Mrs.
Yes.
They have one for Mrs. Wright.
And tell Nancy, I think she's doing a tremendous job on the drug.
Yeah, she really is.
Oh, I think it's fantastic.
You know, that just say no thing. Mm-hmm. She was speaking to some students in Oakland, California, and one of them asked, what do you do if they... And she said, just say no. That's the answer to a question. Today, there are over 10,000 just say no clubs.
Oh,
yeah.
And I think that we're going to move that more today.
Yes.
Because the children are our future. And you can't walk around with crazy kids.
Well,
thank you very much for having us in.
Thank you for the meeting.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
The attempt being to see if we could provide top-down guidance to our respective bureaucracies so as to improve the prospects for a productive summit meeting later this year here in the United States. And the next day, I instructed George to indicate to Foreign Minister Shevardnadze that we thought the proposed preparatory meeting was a positive approach, but we wouldn't be in any position to accept it and couldn't give an answer until after the Danilov matter was settled. And that is to say, after they agreed to his release. And once they did agree to that, why, we then told him that our choice would be of the countries he'd selected, Iceland, and suggested the dates we're going. And the choice of the location was intended to emphasize the private preparatory nature of the meeting in some European country that had been proposed. The date was in response to his and my desire to move ahead the summit planning as much as possible. And it was important that we get whatever top-down guidance that he and I might agree on nailed down as much as possible especially if there's to be any hope for a true summit meeting here. And first, we're going into this meeting, I think, with a very strong position. This is a meeting that he very much wanted, but is very much, I think, in our own best interests also. And second, I believe face-to-face that maybe can deal with a position of pretty good strength with our counterpart. But it's important that we do not let the agenda in Iceland be limited to arms control, as they apparently are talking and would seem to indicate that's their desire. We think that regional conflicts, human rights, and bilateral issues will be equally important as a part of the agenda. And if the discussions there are successful, they should move us closer to agreements. I think that a meeting of this kind can only succeed if our government is united. You've heard me say this over and over again, and I can't stress the importance enough. I need your bipartisan support. On occasions in the past where it was clearly in the national interest to unite, we've done this, and I have every confidence we'll do so again on this occasion. So I'd like to make a special appeal to you. It's exceedingly difficult for me to enter into discussions with the Soviets with legislative restrictions applying to the very areas that are under negotiations with them. I ask you not to tie my hands or undermine my negotiating position. Each of you are key to any chance we have of proceeding with a united government. And I appreciate very much your efforts to help make this trip a success. And if you will give me your trust and confidence, I pledge to you I won't give anything away or I won't let you down. Now I'm going to ask George if he'll comment on the meeting in Iceland, its agenda, and your developments.
President, I'll stand if I may, so I can see him.
I'm Wendy Mount, Mr. President. So happy to see you. May I please go on the roll, Mr. Wells? I'm going to stick with President. I wouldn't want to stuck up. Thank you.
Yeah, that's great.
Mr. President, so nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
And we're proud that you're going to sign it today.
Hey, Mr. President. Great.
So I'm going to say it for you. Thank you very much, Mr. President. We've got some flowers at the New York State Poets Association. We also have a beam porcelain rose collection for you as well.
I understand that. Well, I think that maybe it'll take place over there after we sign.
I follow from Texas.
Time. Right.
See you.
See you.
No, not the roses.
Yes.
Mr. President.
Hello.
How are you?
Just fine.
Nice to meet you.
Well, it's been a long time since I've created a rose plant.
Long time since I've been president, too.
Bill Flynn from the Children's Service. So nice to meet you. Pleasure indeed.
Mr. President, Dayton Engineer. Also, Wilson Corp. Rose Wilson.
Nice to see you.
Mr. President, I'm down there.
Well, pleased to have you. My pleasure.
Mr. President.
Well, I want to
get everybody situated here.
It's still signed, and it's right, and I think it's wonderful of all of you to be here for this, because I know that the rose has grown in every state of the Union, so I think it's really appropriate that the past has turned out to be our national flower.
Oh, thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Mr. President, my right.
Thank you so much. We have a beautiful gift from Helen Bean.
To add
the
green
collection at the White House. And now that you have all the birds, you can start having the roses.
Well, that's beautiful. I'm a great fan of the beam artwork, and I had not seen this. It's beautiful. Well, thank you very much.
By the way, Mr. President, the rose growers of the state of New York, and a letter from our governor, deeply appreciate the signing of this resolution tonight.
Well, thank you very much. My goodness. All I did was write my name. You keep it all.
From your fellow Californians and all the people in Pasadena, we'd like to give you these roses and congratulate you and all of the American people on a great new national flag.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Grab a kiss while you can.
I used to, there was a time when for several years there, and I used to lunch once every year with the tournament roses queen at the court, because I was broadcasting the rose parade. And incidentally, to those who don't know about that rose parade, you can set your clock by the program and what's going by on the parade. Never seen it before. They have you right to the minute. What float will be going by, and that's exactly when it comes by.
That's right.
Well, this is all beautiful. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm going to be a big man.
Thank you, Mr. President. We appreciate your time. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. Give me to the bar. Yes, thank you again. Very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. I was in Washington. I lose my brain 2 weeks. It's so sad.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.